The American people have a right to be angry. Angry that the administration has declined to provide a government witness for today's hearing. It's time for the administration to explain to Congress and to the American people the reasoning behind the newest extension of the so-called joint plan of action. Once again, the Iranians wanted even more time to talk, and the President unwisely agreed to it. So I'm concerned about Iran's ability to continue its deliberate pattern of delay and distraction. With the most recent extension of the interim agreement, Iran is gaining more time, gaining access to billions in additional funds held abroad, and gaining relief from specific sanctions. Instead of being limited and temporary, as President Obama promised, the sanction relief appears to be boundless and never-ending. It's crystal clear that the sanctions caused overwhelming economic pressure, and it is that pressure that brought the Iranian regime to the negotiating table over its nuclear program. The administration has already admitted to the fact. Instead of a policy designed to tighten the economic pressure, this administration seems to be rewarding the Iranians' continued stall tactics. Sanctions relief has certainly failed to get a favorable final agreement. The past 6 years of failed negotiations have shown that we cannot simply talk the Iranian regime out of its illicit nuclear program. Instead of endless discussion, we need security. It's clearly going to take tougher sanctions to get us where we need to be, and that is totally dismantling of Iran's illicit nuclear program. So while the President seems desperate to announce any sort of a deal with the Iranians, the American people can't afford a bad deal or more years of delay. Without increased pressure from America, Iran will continue to enjoy relief from sanctions without dismantling their nuclear program. So I would call on the President to make good on his remarks from the State of the Union, the 2014 State of the Union. He promised that he would, quote, be the first to call for more sanction if Iran failed to complete an agreement. He can do two important things right now to keep his word. One, reinstate full sanctions. The sanctions relief the administration continues to give to Iran removes the urgency for them to complete a final deal. It's time to reimpose those sanctions now to renew urgency on Iran. And second, he can call on Congress to pass a bill to impose new sanctions to compel Iran to complete a final agreement before the end of this year. So I'm ready to increase sanctions and stop Iran from building a nuclear weapon.